Hello. This is part 3 of my video, which is called The Secret of Inertia. Let's see what characteristics inertron should have to be able to explain the existence and behavior of inertia. 1. The number of inertrons is much greater than the number of all the other elementary particles together. 2. All particles having inertia attracts them until attracting as many inertrons they possibly can. The maximum number of inertrons for that particular particle to carry. 3. Particle with smallest inertia binds at least one inertron to itself. 4. Besides inertrons bound to particles, there is a huge number of free inertrons remaining, which are found everywhere in space. 5. Inertrons are mutually neutral, but when aroused, they reject against each other. 6. When the body is affected by force, the atomic balance in the body disrupts, causing bound inertrons to radiate its repulsive inertronic energy to space, which arouses free inertrons. 7. One bound inertron always radiates the same power, independent of the strength of the force acting on the body. 8. Free inertrons are not affected by gravitational or any other force. Elementary particles which have bound inertrons are the only one affected. Now let's take a look at how these features of inertron brings up the phenomenon of inertia. Imagine two bodies collided in deep space, the space between galaxies, where there are no stars or other celestial bodies, and where the effects of gravity and various cosmic radiation are insignificant. Figure 1. According to the Newton's action-reaction law, body 1 is acting with force F1 on body 2, and body 2 is acting with force F2 on body 1, where F1 equals F2. Consider now body 1 acting with force F2. Let's see what will happen and how inertia will appear. Figure 2. Force F2 disrupts atomic balance in body 1. Consequently, bound inertrons begin to emit excitation radiation in direction of the force and it spreads in space. Further on, bound inertrons start to act on free inertrons, which begin to emit its repulsive energy in all directions, acting repulsive on bound inertrons, but also to more and more free inertrons, creating repulsive inertron network in the universe. Repulsion between inertron network radiation and bound inertrons radiation leads to resistance of the body 1 to the force F2. Inertia begins to act. When force F2 stops to act, atomic balance in body 1 is established and the excitation radiation of bound inertrons is stopped. Repulsive network of free inertrons is turned off. Inertia ceases to act, and body one continues to move freely through space. Figure 3. So, the tendency of the body to resist to the effect of the force, inertia, isn't any inner property of a body, but the consequence of the interactions of bound and free inertons. It also means that the cosmic space between celestial bodies is not empty, but filled with free inertons. And because inertia acts equally in the vicinity of the celestial bodies and far away from them, hence the conclusion that the free inertons are not affected by gravity, as it would otherwise lead to their clustering in the vicinity of the celestial bodies. So there would be a greater inertia. So there would be a greater inertia. And far from celestial bodies would be less inertia, since free inertons would be diluted. This is end of part 3. Thank you.